Early today, police deployed heavily at New Nile Bridge in Jinja and eventually arrested Dr. Besigye for the second time this week as he headed to the town. Besigye had been scheduled to visit victims of a collapsed building in Jinja. At least five people were killed when a three-story building collapsed while under construction. After paying his commiserations, Besigye was then scheduled to speak during a radio talk show on Busoga 1 FM. However, he was blocked and initially kept in his car. He was towed in his vehicle to Nalufenya police station. His would-be host on radio was also arrested.
And one of the officers has told me that they are barring me to commit an offence. Of which offence? I'm told it is to host Dr. Besigye.
One person, but he can not allow the officer to suffer because of one person. We have a lot of work to do since at 7 we are here being detained.
We are not allowing that. We are telling whoever is concerned, they have to release Kano by all means.
Police spokesperson Fred Enanga explained the police action.
We don't see any purpose on the side of Dr. Kizza Besigye to go and revisit, reconstruct a scene of crime that is still being managed. So our officers temporarily held him at Nalufenya.
The place is cleared, then you say you are going to visit the site. Where was he at the time when the building collapsed?
Asked about the matter, the resident district commissioner said Besigye's reasons for visiting the district were suspect.
He's mobilizing people purportedly to create a militia group that will guard the 2021 elections. That's the intelligence that we have. But when he's coming this way, he hides in the name of visiting the victims who were affected by the collapsed building. Talking on radio, I think he should give us a break.
By the time this report was compiled, Besigye was still at Nalufenya, as police said they would drive him back to Kampala.